First of all, I think it's always prudent to mention that there are a billion stars in our galaxy, and there's a billion galaxies out there. And do we honestly believe that in the whole of what is out there that there is nothing out there which is intelligent? I think this would be very presumptuous of us. We are very, very young. The Earth is very, very young. It's known to scientists and astronomers alike. And there are obviously many, many more places out there which are much older than us. And initially scientists said, well look, the climates and the conditions on some of these planets will not sustain life. And purely and simply because they're so hostile. But only recently that thing has been totally reversed in view of a situation which developed in Romania, where some engineers were actually building a nuclear power station, and they were laying piles into the ground to put the power station on. And they came to a hard rock surface in the ground which they couldn't penetrate, so they used explosives to blow this thing open. And they found caves an underground which had been sealed for over several million years, totally sealed. But when they entered these caves, they actually found life inside the caves, and I say life in the form of insects of various types, scorpions, beetles, spiders, who had not seen during the sort of the course of their evolution, they'd never ever seen light. Therefore none of these creatures had eyes. But what baffled the scientists when they started to look at this deeper was that the only form of food, because these caves were totally sealed, the only form of food within these caves was hydrogen sulfide, which of course is a strong acid, a powerful acid. And when they looked at it further, they found that the waste products of these insects and creatures was sulfuric acid. Now, if we have creatures living which can eat acid and excrete acid, it then stands to reason that creatures can survive on other hostile areas, and they will evolve in accordance with that hostile area where they emanate from. And consequently, it changes the whole thing around. We can no longer turn around and say, because that planet is hostile, that can't have life on it. And we have always had these preconceived ideas. What do we expect an alien to look like? We all tend to form our own opinions of these things, and we always expect it to have two arms and two legs and a head like us. Cool,